Hello everyone and welcome to the third episode of Shutter Tales. I am Mahima Kriti and today we are going to talk about the second gem of the holy trinity of photography, shutter speed. So what is shutter speed and how can you manipulate it and get creative with it? So let's get started. Shutter speed or exposure time by definition is the amount of time in which the shutter of your camera remains open, allowing light to fall onto the sensor or film of your camera. A higher shutter speed means less time of exposure of the sensor, and a low shutter speed means exposing the sensor for a long time to light. The shutter speed is expressed in camera by the unit of second, which is the time you want to keep your sensor exposed for. It can range from as low as 1 upon 4000 of a second to 30 seconds or even higher. You can also go for bulb mode, which basically keeps the shutter open as long as you want. Now all that is well and good in theory, but how do you implement it while taking a photo? Let's find out. So suppose I want to take a picture of my friend riding a bicycle as he zips past me. He's pedaling fairly fast. And I want to freeze him in my picture. So I set the shutter speed at say 1 by 500 and take his photo. We get this. Now if I want to portray the fact that he is in motion, I need to make him appear as a blur. To do that, I decrease my shutter speed to say 1 by 15 seconds and expose it. We get this. So you can clearly differentiate the two outcomes. Also, we use a tripod for a low shutter speed because no matter how steady your hands are, it will shake. Trust us on that. And the shake will introduce a blur in your photo. Now, one thing you have to keep in mind is a lower shutter speed means more exposed time. Hence, more light will be entering the sensor. Conversely, a higher shutter speed means less exposed times. Hence, less light will be entering the sensor. So, for the same ISO and aperture settings, a low shutter speed image will appear brighter than a higher shutter speed image. Like in this example, you can clearly see how shutter speed affects the brightness of the same scene. So once you get the concept of this feature, you can use it to creatively suit your purpose. Using low shutter speed, you can do long exposure photography and capture light trails and motion blurs. Using fast shutter speed, you can freeze fast-changing moments like creating a splash in the water or in-action photography. The possibilities are limited by your imagination. So that's it for me today. Hope you guys liked the video. Please hit the like, share and subscribe button and hop into the comment section for any questions. And we'll see you in the next video. Till then, get creative.